नमस्ते चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट ए न्यू लेसन। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द न्यू लेसन, ऑब्जर्व द पिक्चर दैट इज देयर ऑन द स्क्रीन चिल्ड्रन। सो फ्रॉम दिस पिक्चर कैन यू अंडरस्टैंड एनीथिंग? यस ऑफ कोर्स। सो व्हेन यू विल ऑब्जर्व दिस पिक्चर, यू आर फाइंडिंग 4-6 डिफरेंट पिक्चर्स इन इट। इन दैट सम आर लाइक योर अम्ब्रेला, कैप, कार, your plant, some kids are playing their mouse. So by these six items or six things that are present in this picture, you are able to group these things into two different categories. So the first one you are seeing, that is all the six pictures, you are picking the similarities or the same features in them, like some are able to move, some are able to grow. So the basic character in the living organisms, that is growth. So now, basing on that, you started dividing the six things into different groups. Yes. So when you differentiated, that time you are observing the similarities and even differences in the living organisms or in the things that you are given to you. Yes. So now we bifurcated, we differentiated or classified the things that are present here into two different groups based on the similarities and differences. So the main difference is the things that are there here. Yes. All these we are saying them as a non-living things because they cannot grow. And here these things, these are the living things, they can able to grow. Yes. So that was the one difference. Based on that, now they have bifurcated or divided. And now here, if you will see the similarities in them, we will find the growth, movement, breathing. These are the similarities here. And same, no growth, breathing, that is the similarity here. So now, based on the differences and similarities, what all the things that are given to you, we can group them. Such grouping of things into different types, it is called your classification. So in our today's class, children, we are going to learn about your block 5, that is living organisms classification, grouping of living organisms. Okay. So today we are going to start a new block, that is grouping of living organisms. Already from the first picture that you had gone through, you understood that grouping of things based on the similarities and differences is the criteria. So in this chapter, if you will see the first keywords that we will come across in our today's class, that is grouping. Grouping means arranging things or people in different groups or types based on the similarities and differences. Similarities means common features. Grouping means to arrange the things or people in different groups based on similarities and differences. Okay.
Arrange things or people in different groups based on similarities and differences.
Okay. So grouping.
Grouping to arrange things or people in different groups based on similarities and differences.
So the second keyword that we will come across, that is your bacteria. Bacteria are the some form of living organisms that they can live in all the type of habitat. All the type of habitat is saying that aquatic, they can live in water, they can live in air, they can live on land, they can live in warm areas, they can live in cold climatic areas. So irrespective to the habitat, bacteria are a form of living organisms that can present in all the type of habitats and we cannot see them with our naked eye. So every time if we want to observe bacteria, we have to go through that through microscope. So bacteria, it is a type of living organisms that are living in all the type of habitats and we cannot see them with our naked eyes.
Bacteria, living things that can live in all types of habitats and we cannot see with the naked eye.
Okay. Same manner, the third keyword that we will come across, that is your fungi. Fungi are a type of living organisms that cannot make their own food. A special type of living organisms which cannot make their own food, that are called your fungi.
Fungi, living things that cannot make their own food.
Okay, so these are some of the keywords that we will come across in our today's class, children. So let's have a small activity. Observe the given picture very carefully, children, and start drawing a tabular column like this in your white paper side of your classwork. Divide the table into three different columns. So the first column, it is your serial number. The second column is type of living organism. Second column I'm writing here. The second column heading, that is type of living organism. And the third one is examples. So divide the column into three different groups. Table into three different groups. First is your serial number. Second is your type of living organism. And third one is examples. So we are going to complete this table by observing this given picture. So have a clean observation of this given picture, children. Yes? Okay. So the given picture, if you will see, it is dividing the living forms into some different groups. At first, let us go with the different living organisms which are present in our surroundings, which are green in color. Can you tell what are those living forms which are present in our surroundings which are green in color? Very good, absolutely. Those living forms are your plants. Those are your plants. So plants are the living forms which are able to prepare their own food by photosynthesis process. Yes, even in plant also you are having different shaped plants. Like here you can see a cone shaped conifer plant is present, moss is present, fern is present, normal plants are present, whatever it may be. Plants means a group of living organisms which can prepare their own food, that are called your plants. So in your tabular column which you already had drawn, so the first serial number, it is 1, and the type of living organism, that are plants. So in examples place, write any two examples like neem plant, fern, croton, like that you can write any plants. And even plants classification also we completed in our earlier classes. Some plants, they live in water, set them as an aquatic plants. Some plants are present in the mountain regions. Some are insectivorous plants, some are parasitic plants. So in detail about the plants we already completed. Okay, so in the tabular column, the first serial number, that is your plants, you can write any two examples of the plants. Okay, so plants are the living organisms which can make their own food by a process called photosynthesis. Okay, so now let us move to another type of living organisms that are seen in our areas. So in our areas, other than plants, if you will observe carefully, we even find some other organisms which can crawl, yes, on the surface, which can eat, feed on the nectar of the flowers, which can fly, which can walk, which can squid in the water. So different variety of living organisms that are present in our surroundings, which cannot make their own food, but they can exhibit growth, development, breathing, movement, everything. So the type of living organisms which are unable to prepare their own food materials and very larger in size, we are saying them as a animals. So again, in animals also you will see that some animals are crawling on the surface, like your earthworms, snakes. Some animals are present in water only, so we are saying them as an aquatic animals. Some animals can fly. Some are having a huge body structure. They can walk on the surface. So animals means another type of living organisms which are unable to prepare their own food but can exhibit growth and development in them. Such group of living organisms, we are saying them as a animals. So in your tabular column, the next one, serial number 2, that is animals. So animals, example, any two example, you can write an ant, human, monkey, wolf, tiger, starfish, octopus, earthworm. All these are the best examples of animals. So now, after plants and animals, let us move to the third one, that is fungi. So what are fungi? Fungi means a group of living organisms, which are neither plants nor animals. We are saying that they are neither plants. Like plant, they cannot prepare food. So they are neither plants nor animals. Like animals, they are not depending on the plant or other animals. So a specified group of living organisms that always feed on feeding means eating, that is always feeding on dead and decomposing materials. That means your rotten vegetables, waste food, moist areas, moist bark, all such dead and decomposing materials that are feeded by the fungi. A very specialized group of living organisms which are eating the dead materials or decomposing materials as a food, that are called your fungi. That's what we are now saying, that fungi is a group of organisms that can be neither plants or animals. Like plants, they cannot perform photosynthesis, so you can't place the fungi in plants. Like animals, they are not depending on other plants for food, so you even can't place them in animals group. A very specialized group of living organisms which are always depending on the dead and decomposing materials as their food. That is your third. So in the tabular column, already we completed two now. One is your plants, examples. Second one is your animals, examples. Now the third category, that is your fungi, and that is your fungi and examples. Like mushrooms, you will get in the supermarket. Mushrooms are the very good examples of your fungi. Mushrooms are edible fungi. But all the mushrooms, edible fungi are limited. All the mushrooms, they are not edible. But majority of the mushrooms which are grown under sterilized units, that are the edible fungi. Okay, so now sometimes when you will see the bakery items like your pastries, cakes, biscuits, they are very soft in their nature, isn't it? Of course. Okay, so another group of living organisms, okay, which are now not only feeding on the dead and decomposing material, which are even used in the bakeries, that is your yeast. Yeast is a type of fungi that is used in the bakeries, which will act on the batter and they will soften the batter. So another use of your fungi, that is your yeast, which is helping as a softening agent in the bakery industry. So now third category of fungi, third type of fungi, third example of fungi, that is your molds. Did any time notice that your mother, when she will leave the bread openly in the air, grayish color powder structures that will start forming? Such structures are called your molds. So till now we have completed three types. One is your plants, second is animals, and the third is fungi. So now other than these, at the top, if you will see, these are a specialized group of living organisms. Yes, these are a specialized group of living organisms which can live in all the type of habitats. They won't see whether it is a desert, hot area, it's a winter, it's a cool area. They won't observe that thing at any time. A very specialized group of organisms which are grown in all the nutrient which are grown, a specialized group of living organisms which are microscopic in their nature. They are microscopic in their nature means if you want to see the bacteria, you have to observe the bacteria under microscope. A very specialized group of living organisms which are grown in all the type of habitats, irrespective to the temperature, irrespective to the resources, they are present in all the type of habitats which are seen under the microscope. Those are called your bacterias. So in your tabular column, the fourth heading, fourth serial number, that is your bacterias, and examples of the bacterias you will learn in your higher classes. So now the third category of animals, we are seeing them as a protists. The fifth category of animals, we are seeing them as a protists. So protists are a very specialized living forms which are present in the protists are a very, very, very specialized living forms which are including the algae that is found on the water and even the protozoans like amoeba. Very specialized. This is your amoeba. This one. Okay, a very specialized living forms that are present in the water. A stagnant water or a moist walls are there, na, you will see the formation of a greenish patch on it. That is nothing but your algae. And algae can prepare its own food. Okay, a very specialized group of organisms which are present. Which are including algae, which is growing on the stagnant water surface or a moist walls. And the second one is your protozoans, which are like your mosquitoes, cockroaches, etc. Protozoans, a very specialized organisms which will enter into our body and they will cause damage. So the fifth heading here you are going to keep, that is your protists. So the best examples for protists is algae, amoeba. Okay, so these are the best examples of protists. Okay children, so by seeing this chart, complete the tabular column accordingly. This is your activity part. So now let's have a quick look. Now let's have a quick look on the video.
Just as we put different types of clothes in different sections of our closet, we divide living things on the earth into different groups. These groups are plants, animals, fungi, bacteria, and protists. The classification helps us to study the differences, similarities, and relationships between different living things.
This slide, it is okay children. So now the first question, after observing the video and activity explanation, let's see few questions. What are the groups into which living organisms can be classified? Can anybody tell what are the different groups? Very good. Animals are living things are classified into plants, animals, bacteria, fungi, and protists. So like that, five different groups of animals are classified by the scientist. Okay, bacteria, fungi, algae. Fungi is your algae is your protist. Bacteria, protists, fungi, plants, and animals, these are the five different group of animals. So here in the flow chart, if you will observe, classification of living things. The first category, that is your animals, where we will come. The second one is your plants. The third one is bacteria. Fourth one is your fungi. And the fifth one, that is your protists. So, five different type of groups that are seen in the living organisms. So, now the question is, why should we classify the living organisms? Why should we classify the living organisms? So, when you will observe the classification of living organisms, so the classification of living organisms, see, what is the need of classifying living things? So, the need of classifying living things is that it will help us to study the complete knowledge about the living organism. And even this particular classification, it is always done based on the similarities and differences in them. So, because of that, everyone in that family will understand the need, and they will classify accordingly. Yes. So, why do we need to classify living things? Means for the better study of the living organism. Yes. They are classified based on the similarities and differences, for the identification of new living organism from the pre-existing one. Yes, these are the two reasons why the living organisms are classified. Okay, so now the next question, if you will see, there are variety of animals. There are variety of animals found us around us. We can further divide animals into subgroups. How and why? So, the variety of animals that are present in our surroundings are even further divided into subgroups. So, the subgroups like your animals which are truly present in water, that is your fishes, animals that can live both in water and on land, that are your amphibians, then reptiles, then birds, and then mammals. Like that, animals are even also can be classified into some different groups. So now the next question, if you see, what's time for the sum? Now let us see with the workbook, children. Workbook. So, in the workbook, the first question, if you will see, here is the first question. They are asking you to write, tick the correct sentence above the classification. So, now they are asking to tick the sentences about the classification. The first statement is, it is the process of sorting things into different groups. Is this particular classification is a method of sorting of things into different groups? Yes, that is true. Now the B statement, it is that it is the process of noise fixing things. So is this is a process of fixing things? Absolutely no. No. Okay, now the third statement, that is, it sorts things into different groups according to their connection features. That is also no. Animals, when they are placed together, they are placed in their appropriate groups. So, if they are... Yes, children, let us see the workbook once again. So, the first question here, they are asking, tick the correct sentences and about classification. So, A1 in that is, it is the process of sorting things into different groups. So, classification we are doing based on the similarities and differences to divide the into different groups. So, this is your correct answer. The second statement is the process of mixing things. In classification, we will mix the things. No, this is the wrong answer. Now, the third question, if you will see, what is the third question? So, in third question, if you will see, It sorts things into different groups according to their common features. Of course, the common feature, we are using the word similarity. Okay, now the fourth question, if you will see, it is a scientific way to organize and study things. Absolutely, this is correct. Classification, it is a scientific way to study the things. Okay, children, now let us move to the second question. In the second question, if you will see, look at the pictures and complete the chart. So, two for done for you, children. So, look at the picture now and complete the chart. So, in this picture, the first clue, that is, these are the bacteria. Now, the second picture, that is your fungi. So, can you please tell flower, it comes under which category? Very good. It comes under your plants. Now, what is this? Very good. It comes under your animals. Okay. So, now let us move to the third one and let's see the third question. Write two reasons why the living things are classified into different groups. Any two reasons why the living things are classified into different groups. The first and foremost reason is understanding the relationships between the organisms. The second one is your classification makes the study of scientists very easily. And the third one is identifying the new things from the given features, that is your similarities and differences between the organisms. Okay, children? Yes. Now, in that, yes, in that, now the second, third question, if you will see, why do we divide plants and animals into subgroups? So, plants and animals, further they are divided into subgroups. So, why? So, plants and animals, they are divided further subgroups based on their similarities and differences. Like some plants, they will give flowers, some won't give flowers. So, animals, if you will see, animals of different sized, shaped animals are present, and some animals can crawl on the land, some animals are walking, some animals are flying. So, like that, every animal based on its body, it is having some specific features in it. Okay, children, listen the video carefully. Yes, so now another practice, three questions are there in your textbook, volume book, if you will see. So, in volume book, page number 34, if you will see, in practice questions, the first question is, on what basis do we group things and how is it important? On the basis of similarity and differences, we will group things. And what is its importance? So, this classification is very much important to study about the organisms. Okay, now in that, the second question, if you will see, write three reasons why when we need to classify the things. Write the three reasons why we need to. So, we need to classify the things to study about the things betterly, and we need to classify the things based on the similarities and differences, and even we need to classify. So, right, they are asking how is the need of classification to stand better study of the living organisms. So, in that, the three question, if you will see, a hollow is the the third question, if you will see, how is the classification of plants different from the animals? So, in third A, they are asking how is the classification of plants different from animals? So, in plants, if you will see, the classification, it is done by the food preparation process. Plants can prepare the food material, so they are placed in one group. Animals cannot prepare their food material, so they are placed in the second group. So, in the practice questions, third question, statement B, if you will see, they are asking that, write three differences between fungi and bacteria. Now they are asking three differences between fungi and bacteria. So the first difference is bacteria are microscopic organisms, fungi are naked organisms. Bacteria are present in all the different habitats. Fungi are present only where there is dead and decomposing material. Yes? Okay. And another one is your bacterium will survive in all the different type of habitats. Okay. So, observe the video children. Go through the video and start completing your classwork. Okay children?